Hey guys, welcome to Found Flicks. It's been a pretty tough journey for Leatherface, the new Texas Chainsaw Massacre prequel, which has been sitting in the can completely done with no release date until recently. This led many people to believe that maybe the studio didn't want to release it and that it maybe just wasn't very good. But come on, how bad could it be? I mean, there's no way that it's worse than Texas Chainsaw 3D, which you see that I own, mainly because of the lenticular cover. I also was interested in this and I had a little more faith in it because it's got the two French guys who directed the amazing Inside from 2007. That movie is successful at being both brutal and very violent with some intense scenes, and them directing did give me some hope that the new Leatherface was actually going to be possibly good. And now we can finally see for ourselves. A brand new restricted Red Band trailer came out just today, finally giving us our first glimpse at what Leatherface has in store. So let's check out the trailer and I'll give you my reaction and review. And I will be pausing it sometimes and doing the skips around if something really interesting happens, so sorry about that. If you're trying to watch the trailer without me talking on it, I put a link in the description below. All right, sounds pretty spooky already. Looks like we got AT&T to thank for this thing finally coming out, huh? Uh-oh, that sounds pretty creepy. I guess he's at his little workbench there. Oh, that's definitely like a recreation of the shot from the original with the dolly behind the girl. I know there's like Steven Dorff's daughter gets kidnapped or murdered and, it's blamed on one of these kids. He ends up at a mental hospital. Oh, she's awesome too from The Conjuring and a bunch of stuff. But yeah, getting a chainsaw for a present. That's pretty amazing. Oh, he's already putting masks together too. Ooh, that didn't look good. Oh, there's Dorff. Supposedly out for revenge, or he's driven by vengeance. Uh-oh. Ooh, goodness, sorry, I gotta go back for that. Yeah, I mean, already this looks pretty intense with the scene at kind of a diner where I'm assuming it's these four kids that have escaped the mental institution and are out causing havoc out in the world, but that, yeah, look at that. Ooh, check please. All right, sorry about that. That was just too juicy. Oh, and then she stabs that other guy. Oh, watch out, lady. She's already covered in blood. Oh, yeah, it's not gonna be good. Not good. What? Dorff just straight up shot that lady. Seems like there's gonna be, he's kind of like another villain, I guess, sort of, because he's so driven by her. Oh, that looks pretty intense too. Oh, no. Yikes. Oh, wait, are they being experimented on? What was that? Sorry, I gotta go back again. Looked like the chainsaw was living on its own there. Whoa, man. Should have done this one in 3D, having that chainsaw coming at you. Anyway. He doesn't like his reflection, I guess, there. Oh, Dorff, no! Yeah, wow, that's a pretty sweet shot, too. He's got that chainsaw going there right on Dorff's neck. And you got juicy, juicy blood just streaming off the end of that chainsaw there. Well, well, well. All right. Well, there you go. Wow, I mean, okay. Well, guys, how about that? It actually looks pretty damn good. I mean, I had no idea that it was gonna, I knew those guys and they have a very good style and it looks like they translated that really well into Leatherface. It's like it doesn't even matter if the story or the script is that great. Because visually, that looked amazing. I mean, again, like way more polished and refined than anything we've seen from the series in quite some time. But additionally, it seems to be kind of actively paying homage to the original kind of 70s feel of it too. There's that one shot that I feel like they must have known or doing that on purpose, that it's a recreation of a shot from the original. And true to their nature as well, there is plenty of blood going around in this one too, and they seem to have just, again, made it a lot more brutal. There's not much comedy to it, which is something the precious Chainsaw 3D was a little too comedic, obviously. Had plenty of problems beyond that as well. I'm actually way more excited than I was beforehand because I just didn't know. And again, when something is shelved for any amount of time and that reluctance from a studio to release it, that always kind of makes you a little cautious, but people are gonna wanna watch that. That actually looks good. Nice job, Inside guys. They're French. I'm not gonna try to pronounce their names. I mean, I'm gonna mess it up. So it looks like you got the Leatherface back on track. Steven Dorff, he looks like he's got some real brutality to him as well, you know, kind of making a man a little more evil in general, having that second antagonist in a way. I don't know, it doesn't look like it's gonna turn out so well for Dorf in the end based on that final shot of the trailer though, which was pretty sweet too. All right guys, that'll do it for my look at the Leatherface trailer, but what did you guys think of it? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. What do you think? Did they actually get Texas Chainsaw Massacre back on track after so much time? Make sure to like, subscribe, and follow. Thanks for watching Found Flicks. See you next time.